can you tell me a bit about Locust Robot and how it works?
Yeah, the Locust Robot is a warehouse robot, and it supports the picking and put away operations of a warehouse. So that's something that everybody knows how to do because everybody's been grocery shopping.
Yeah.
So that's exactly what we do in our e-commerce warehouse. We just fulfill orders. So somebody sends in a list of things they want to buy, and we go out on the shelf and put it in a box. So really the robot does that for us and makes it a lot easier and makes it a more pleasant job.
And so do the robots work side by side with people or human coworkers, or are they predominantly working on their own?
Well, no, they work right alongside you. And the idea there is that humans are very evolved. We're very good at picking things up, you know, various shapes and sizes. Robots are not very good at that.
So yeah.
What we try to do is have the robot do things the robot's good at and have the human do things that the humans are good at. And, you know, that we're not really trying to be too far out there on the technology curve. We're just trying to take the technology as it exists today and put it to good use.
I think that's a really great point. I think sometimes it's easy to get caught up in overly futuristic ideas instead of the real concrete applications today.
Yeah, we all watch Star Trek, right?
Yeah, we like can't stop talking about Star Trek over the past few days here. And so do you have like a vision of where you want the technology for the company to be in 5 years?
Oh yeah, I mean, it's hard to predict the future, but I look at this as somewhat like evolution. You know, you just kind of let the circumstances dictate how things should work. And we see just so many different ways we can optimize. So the robots can do so much, and we're operating at such a granular level in the work itself. You know, we know where the people are, we know where the robots are, we know where the products are, and everything's moving and being tracked in real time. So we can really do a lot of really great things. Like,
yeah.
If you're walking down an aisle, I can actually make a robot just sort of appear in front of you as you're moving along. And that kind of optimization, that is an example of an opportunity we have that we can just keep working on forever.
Yeah, and so how are the robots improving productivity?
Well, in that example I gave you of grocery shopping, which, you know, we're all really bad at and all hate to do, it's really, there's really two main things you're doing. One is you're walking down the aisle looking for a product, and the other thing is you're taking a product off the shelf and putting it in a basket. So what we do is we analyze all the behaviors on that, and it may seem like, well, you know, why are you doing that? But we have to do that 20 or 30 million times a year, so, and probably next year 40 million times. So if we can find a more efficient way to do it, it really matters to us. And so what we do is we have the robot do as much of that job as it can, and so the robot does the walking for you, and you do some walking, but minimal. And then we make it very easy for you to pick the item off the shelf, confirm it by scanning it and putting it in the box. So really, we've analyzed every movement and made it as efficient as possible.
And how did you personally get into robotics?
Well, that was actually, I'm a reluctant roboticist. when we first started our logistics business, which we have two companies, one sells robots and one buys robots, but our logistics business buys the robots, and originally we started out with another company's robot. It was a company that ultimately got acquired by Amazon. And then when we sort of realized that we couldn't buy that robot anymore, we said, oh my gosh, we've got to come up with an alternative. So I scoured the globe looking for a replacement robot and was somewhat disappointed with what I found. And then I also realized that if we were to work with someone else's robot, then that would make their robot company more valuable.
Okay.
And then they might sell that to Amazon.
Got it. It could happen again,
and we'd just be right back where we started. So we said, we got to own this technology. So that's what we did.
That's cool. So you kind of got into it by way of wanting to make sure the company was positioned in the most effective way.
Yeah, well, I had a problem to solve.
Yeah.
You know, I had all these customers that needed me to deliver their goods, and all my contracts and all my commitments to them were based on having a robot to help me do that. And then all of a sudden, I didn't have a robot. So I was pretty much in trouble, you know?
Yeah.
That was a bad day.
And so what was the timeline like in developing the first robot in the company?
Well, we started out really with just, you know, an idea. We had, we went to a catalog and we bought a simple robot. And what's really funny is the robot we have today is very much like that very first robot we bought out of a hobbyist catalog. But we built a tiny little robot and we realized very quickly that the robots don't have to do much. They just have to go forward and they have to go backward and they have to spin. That's what these mobile robots do now. But the real hard part is in the software. So we had to do things like navigation, we had to do collision avoidance, we had to be able to communicate with the robot, we had to put intelligence in the robot, sensors and all sorts of other things to make it work. And we just kept building better and better robots. Then we finally designed our own robot. And that took altogether about 3 years and quite a lot of money, maybe $15 million.
Woo.
Yeah.
And so how do you think that workers feel about the robot? Are they receptive to it, kind of like nervous, like, ah, don't take my job?
You know, we haven't seen that at all.
Yeah.
It's kind of a funny trend that's happening. It's sort of hard to sort out, but retail is losing customers and e-commerce is gaining customers, and it's happening sort of at the same rate. It's almost dollar for dollar. So we're seeing people in the retail space lose jobs, and then we're seeing people in the warehouse space gain jobs. And the problem we're having is we can't find enough people to do these jobs. So we're sort of in this box where we need the robot just to do the work. And
yeah.
I think if you go to any warehouse, industrial park, anywhere in the United States, you'll see help wanted signs, and the wage rates continue to go up. And you know, the business is, it's a challenging business. It's a hard job. It's not a lot of fun to do it all day. So we're just trying to address that problem.
Yeah, I love just the applicable nature of the technology.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of, I mean, obviously we all love sci-fi and we all love these great out there technologies. But I think one of the things that we sort of quickly realized was it's much easier to build a robot if you know exactly what it needs to do.
Yes.
And since we knew that part of it really well, it didn't take us that much time to actually build a new robot. And when we were done with it, we knew it would do the job because we knew the job that it needed to do exactly. We knew every little detail about it. So now this robot is really quite elegant. It just does only what it needs to do, no more, no less. It's just a great solution for the problem.
Well, Bruce, thank you so much. It's been a pleasure. Thanks, everyone, for tuning in. That's it for now.